It is 6:30. I'm calling the meeting to order. Please all rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Mrs. Trevette?
Present.
Mrs. Felton? Mr. Hubler?
Here.
Mr. Lipsky?
Here.
Mrs. Ross is here. Mrs. Servio?
Here.
And Dr. Spencer?
Here.
System one.
Thank you. So due to the current corona pandemic and mandated by the governor of the state of Michigan, our district has changed the structure for tonight's board meeting to accommodate both the public and the board and the district while following all issued requirements and laws. While we understand and support the need to stay home and stay healthy, there are a few essential business items that need to be addressed. We will continue to function as a district and vote on these essential items. As the situation continues to evolve, we look forward to moving toward a complete remote access meeting as essential items present themselves. Tonight, our district and the board will be participating both remotely and in person. If the room attendance exceeds the 10-person allowance, we are prepared with both video and technology to provide individuals the ability to remotely watch the meeting in the Wheeler Center in different designated areas. The district has posted a virtual public comment participation option for our patrons to address the board during this meeting. It is listed on our website, which is lc-ps.org. Please note that with the conference call feature, there is a delay when individuals are speaking, and it is important not to speak over each other during this process. I will ask if there is any discussion after every item, so please speak only when addressed. Everyone will have an opportunity to speak and ask questions. Tonight, all voting items will be roll called during the meeting. With that, I am seeking for the first item of the evening, the approval of the agenda for March 23rd, 2020 regular board meeting. Do I have a motion to approve?
Motion.
I have a motion by Mrs. Servio. Do I have support by Mr. Lipsky?
Support.
Roll call, please.
So that was Amy and Adam?
Correct.
Can you all hear me well now?
Yes.
All right, so Amy, is Mr. Sergio?
Yes.
Mr. Lipsky?
Yes.
Dr. Spencer? Dr. Spencer? Dr. Spencer?
Take it up, you.
Terry?
Okay. Okay, this isn't going to help me.
So go ahead and skip her, Sharon.
Yep, so Mrs. Ross says yes. Mr. Hubler?
Here. Yeah.
Approval of agenda? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, and Mrs. Dubé?
Yes. Let's try Dr. Spencer one more time.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Thank you.
7-1.
6-1.
Six one, I'm sorry.
Here.
Wow, 5-1.
That's okay.
We're getting there. Right, 6-1. Hearing of school district patrons, I see none in attendance in the room. We're checking our virtual. We have none on the virtual either. So moving on to the consent agenda, a motion to approve the consent agenda.
Motion.
I have a motion by Mrs. Servio with support by Dr. Spencer. Roll call, please.
Motion on consent agenda, Mrs. Servio?
Yes.
Dr. Spencer?
Yes.
Mrs. Dubé?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
Yeah.
Mr. Lipsky?
Yes.
And Mrs. Ross, yes. So six.
Thank you. Moving on to the next agenda item, the superintendent's report.
Thank you. At the February 25th, 2019 regular board meeting, student 293 was expelled for 180 days for violation 3.7 of the Lance Creuse Public School Code of Conduct. Section 3.7 is for the sale, use, possession of illegal drugs, controlled substances, drug paraphernalia, or other substances portrayed as illegal drugs. The student, per their rights, has petitioned for reinstatement. A reinstatement committee hearing was held on March 4th, 2020, and the committee, which included members of administration, community, as well as board members, is recommending a conditional reinstatement for student 293 to Lance Creuse High School. The conditions of reinstatement are included in your packet with the letter that was sent to the student. So again, the reinstatement committee recommends that the board approve the attached resolution to conditionally reinstate student 293.
Do I have a motion for reinstatement?
Make a motion.
Do I have support?
Support.
Was it Dr. Spence that gave us the first to support?
Amy.
Sharon.
Amy, then Sharon.
Amy, then Sharon. Okay. Any discussion? Questions? Hearing none. Roll call, please. Yes, Mr. Huber.
I would ask, and I appreciate the Senator and person can, for the sake of rapidness and so proud that we're not muted, that when we vote verbally, that we get confirmation that, of the vote. I think that then they also, in order for me in this case, if I vote the vote yes, just to read the vote yes, then go on to the next person. Otherwise, it's somewhat stuck in the dark.
So each person.
I apologize. I intended to do that. Thank you, John. Thank you.
Okay. Whenever you're ready, Mrs. Ross.
Okay. So the reinstatement is 0293. Mrs. Serville.
Yes.
Mrs. Serville votes yes. Mrs. Ross. Mrs. Ross votes yes. Mr. Lipsky.
Yes.
Mr. Lipsky votes yes. Mr. Huber?
Yes.
Mr. Huber votes yes. Mrs. Dubay?
Yes.
Mrs. Dubay votes yes. And Dr. Spencer?
Yes.
Dr. Spencer votes yes. Again, my apologies. I intended to do that. Thank you, John, for that reminder.
And motion carries.
Thank you. The next item is an employee matter on the agenda. The resolution is attached to your login information, and you should have been able to view that. I also attached a letter regarding communication on this issue. And the motion is to consider non-renewal of the employee stated within this resolution. It is, again, let's be clear, it is a multiple step process. At this point, in the March 23rd meeting, we are asking for consideration of non-renewal of this employee, not an actual vote of non-renewal. So I'm looking for a motion to support the resolution that's attached and accompanying documents to consider non-renewal of said employee.
Do I have a motion? I'm sorry?
That was the support from Sharon for that.
Who was the, I need a primary. I need
something. I'll be a primary.
Okay, so Mrs.
I thought I was.
All right. So I have Mrs. Ross with support by Mrs. Serbia.
Yes.
Roll call, please. Or I'm sorry, is there any discussion or questions in regards to the matter? Hearing none. Roll call, please.
This is to consider the non-renewal of an employee. So Mrs. Ross votes yes. Mrs. Sturbill?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturbill votes yes. Mrs. Dubay?
Yes.
Mrs. Dubay votes yes. Patrick Spencer?
Yes.
Patrick Spencer votes yes. Mr. Huber?
Yes.
Mr. Huber votes yes. Ms. Lipsky?
Yes.
Mr. Lipsky votes yes. All six?
Motion carries. Thank you. Human Resources. Oh, I'm sorry, is there anything else from the superintendent?
I'll comment at the end. I'll make some brief comments at the end of the meeting. Thank you.
Okay. Human Resources.
Good evening. Tonight, with the careful consideration of the curriculum department and coordination of the superintendent's office, a description for the director of secondary education is before the Board of Education for your review, input, and hopeful approval so that we can move forward to fill the position. The position, you may recall, was vacated in November of 2019. There have been no deletions of responsibilities from the position since the last time it was reviewed by the Board of Education, but it has been expanded to include things that had been done in that position, primarily athletics, dual enrollment, early college, international academy coordination, and with the consolidation of other departments, something that has been added to this description is facilitating the student advisory and student coalition.
Do I have a motion to approve? Do I have support?
Support by Lipsky.
So I have a motion by Mr. Huebler with support by Mr. Lipsky. Any discussion? Or hearing none, roll call please.
The position for the Director of Secondary Education, Mr. Huebler?
Yes.
Mr. Huebler votes yes. Mr. Lipsky?
Yes.
Mr. Lipsky votes yes. Dr. Spencer?
Yes.
Dr. Spencer votes yes. Mrs. Dubay?
Yes.
Mrs. Dubay votes yes. Mrs. Sturbill?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturbill votes yes. Mrs. Ross? Yes. Mrs. Ross votes yes. All six?
Wonderful. Motion carries. Do we have any other matters from board members? Hearing none, we're going to look at our hearing of school district patrons follow-up. Still none in attendance and none on virtual. Any board member comments?
No, this is out.
I'm sorry?
This is out.
Yes.
I'd like to ask Vicki, if you could please resend the document that shows when each individual has to sign the letter. I appreciate it. I want to make sure that, yeah, please, with the time we're in, I want to make sure that anything that needs to be rescheduled or with the folks at the conference, I want to make sure that we have that covered.
Any other board members? So yes, just to mirror what Mr. Lipsky said in regards to board activities, I guess I would say, and we have winter, spring board workshop that was scheduled for March 30th, that we cancel all board activities that are not essential at this time. We can definitely discuss rescheduling events and rescheduling our meetings that are not necessary or essential action items for the district. We can look at our schedules and reschedule those once we get past this time of closure and look at readdressing those issues. We think right now, moving forward, we just move forward with essential items. We will address April's meetings as we get information from both, like we said, the governor and any mandates that may come. We can address April's meetings at that time. Because this is very fluid, it's very changing, and obviously we're going to make the necessary changes to comply and to keep everyone safe and healthy as well.
So, one thing, this is Amy.
Amy first, and then it moves down.
Could Nikki please send out the next three check signings?
Yeah.
And when the check, when it'll be ready, if it's ready on Wednesday night, let us know so that we can stagger the time to go in and sign it.
Good idea.
Yes. Yep, Nikki's going to send out all the check registry information for us to come in and to be staggered and to make sure that we come in compliance for sure.
Point of order on that.
Terry?
I think when you talk about essentials, and since there are many districts that there is no process where you go through, and as much as we do that, I don't know that it is anything that would be of essential nature. We obviously have to pay our bills when we do vote. So I'm not really sure in this time whether or not the practice of going in and going through that would be more of a voluntary versus an essential, to use the word essential, practice.
Yes. So what we can do is we can have the superintendent look into that and see if there are other options available for us. And because you're right, we do need to keep paying our bills. And currently the way that we do that is through the board does participate in the signing of the check registry. So we can definitely have the superintendent look into other options and see if maybe there is another practice that we can utilize at this time.
This is Amy.
Go ahead, Amy. Thank you, Don, for being patient.
What we could do is Nikki could send the ledgers to people that have to sign it that particular week, and then list all the different areas on an email, and we could just approve it and sign those, and that it would be attached to the ledger after we go through it.
We can look and see what the legality is of that. We can look at and see if that is something that we can actually do.
Okay.
So I move that.
Yes.
Sorry, Don.
Right, I know. Poor Don.
Sorry, Don. Dotting sign holds all the legality potentially for us. So if we have the ability to sign virtually, we could use dotting sign if that is something that the district already uses.
Okay. Don, do you want to go ahead?
Yeah, just if I'm going to have the formal act on it. There's a number of options myself. I'm in the category of Catholic, and so I'm considering that for legal opinion. I think that's a viable concern as far as making personal, sharing personal. My task would be, even though there's a lot of resource material out there, I would say that would suggest MASC does have a COVID-19 page with a tremendous amount of resources from experiences around the state on conduct of meetings, the state's response, which is kept up to date, educational tools, and additional resources. And I would suggest that board members, if they're looking for up-to-date information, that's a great resource.
Okay, why don't we?
Go ahead.
You can put it out there as an option. You should say it. I mean,
yeah. So there is an option that we can do. Hold on, I'm trying to log into my email, and that's always fun.
Well, can we?
Go ahead, Eric.
I'm sorry. It's awkward to make this comment. So I'm just speaking casually. There is a option in Article 1, General, regarding suspension of bylaws. You could. It's a 2/3 vote to suspend. And you could say something general in terms of handling the business of the district. I could get the legal end of that tied up and assume that it was legally permissible unless it was not. So I'm never entitled to break any laws or do anything that's not allowable per state law or federal law. But without the exact text of it, you could enact Section 6 of Article 1, which talks about suspension of bylaws. We could read that. And you could vote, it's a 2/3 vote to approve that for, you could list a duration of time. I've seen statements from other boards regarding during the state emergency or during a period of state emergency. And then, but put a caveat on there that it, you know, must follow all applicable state laws. So it doesn't just suspend every policy or procedure of the board, just those relating to conducting the business of the district normally handled by the check register.
Any discussion on that?
Yeah,
So I just pulled it up. It's a modification or suspension of bylaws during states of emergency is what it states. It says during states of emergency applicable to the district declared by the President of the United States, the governor of the state of Michigan, or another governmental entity with the legal authority to bind the district, the following procedures shall be in effect. So there's one, two.
The last one.
So the last one says, during the pendency of any such state emergency, the board hereby empowers the superintendent to bypass any board policy or bylaws necessary to ensure the continuity of operations, including but not limited to executing contracts, procuring, and the like. This bylaw shall not empower the superintendent to act in a manner that would violate any federal, state, or local law or ordinance, or to take unilateral action in violation of a prior resolution or finding of the Board of Education.
So, Mr. Chair, can you give me the article and the section and the page on that? That's in our bylaws, right?
Not at this time. It is not currently in our bylaws.
That language, I'm sorry, that language can be used. I could verify that if you wanted to. You could vote on it, make reference to it under Section 6 and suspension of bylaws, make reference to performing essential business functions of the district. I could verify that that was done properly, but we wouldn't have to have another meeting, is what I'm trying to say. So if you agree to suspend, it's a two-thirds vote, make reference to that statement that Hillary just read, then it would be, I believe, allowable. And if it was not allowable, I would let you know and wouldn't do it.
Okay, so then what were you reading from? What was that?
It's from Clark Hill.
So what I was reading from was given to us from Clark Hill today in regards to the current situation we find ourselves in. Yes. So
Clark Hill legal opinion. Okay, thank you.
So all of you know that for me personally, I'm not a big person who is in favor of having you vote on something that you haven't read yourself. That's how I've always been. But in regards to the situation that we find ourselves in, it would really be how the board feels as a whole in regards to moving forward. If we do this, if we do vote to empower the superintendent, it does remove the board's responsibility for coming in and signing check registries. It removes the responsibility from the board to have to come into the building for any purposes while this occurrence continues. We are empowering our superintendent to act in this manner. It's really up to the board what you would like to do moving forward in regards to this.
I think it's appropriate. And again, I just know how other boards operate. And I think that our going in and signing the checkbook register and all of that is a higher level of scrutiny that has evolved over time with our board, but it is not one, and Eric, you correct me if I'm wrong, it is not one that is used by most districts.
Oh. I don't know where we're at in terms of most versus others, but I know it's legally permissible to not do that. It is legally permissible to act on it without signatures, but that I couldn't comment as to where other boards are at with that at this time.
So we do vote on it at the end. I mean, so it's kind of nice because we divvied up those duties, and some board members really want to, we'll go line by line and look through them. But in this case, you're to avoid people taking the risk of going into a public building.
Yep, Dan?
Yeah, Clark Hill, our policy service, sent it to us as a option to conduct business of the district, just as we're discussing. So it did come from Clark Hill. It actually was not solicited. They sent it to us as part of our included service. So it is in line with our current policy, and that it's by the same creator as our current policy.
So Sharon?
Yes. Go ahead, Sharon.
So that's all good. I know I've seen some stuff like that too. I'd like to bring to the board's attention, in our Reliance School Board of Education policy and bylaws, Article 1, Section 6, regarding suspension. Just so that last sentence is what I draw our attention to, but I'll read the whole thing. So, Article 1, Section 6, suspension of bylaws and policies. Lessons or policies may be suspended during board meetings by 2/3 vote of the board members present at such meetings. This is the part I want to bring to our attention. Unless amended by the board, the suspended bylaw or policy shall resume force effect upon the adjournment of the board meeting and when suspension occurs. So that's currently in our bylaws, so we can suspend that part also. I just want to make sure that we all know that's in there.
Nikki, can you, where's the...
Any other discussion or comment
Don,
in regards
Don, to... Don,
Don, yes?
Yes, okay, so I see Article 1, Section 6. And you hear me, the and I apologize, I was looking for the article that requires the two board members to
Dad, can you say that one more time? It was a little difficult to hear you.
I understand what you're sharing, but in order to suspend this article, I'm looking for the specific article that requires the two board members on the cover.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm looking for.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah,
that might be...
Nikki's looking at it right now. Nikki's looking through it right now.
Actually, yeah. I have both operating procedures and bylaws
over
here, too.
Do you, Sharon, do you find where it says anything about signing the check registry?
I'm looking right now, so of course, I think we should find it, right?
Right. Sharon, do you have a hard copy in front of you of the policy?
I do.
Can you look in
Article
4? I only have the electronic and it's hard to flip through. Can you look in Article 4, Section 1 under fiscal management? Is it listed there?
This is policy and bylaws?
This is in policy.
Okay, I'm going to say Article 4.
I'm sorry, Article 9. My room is correctly. Sorry. Article 9, Section 1, Fiscal Management. Should be page 37?
Yes,
and
you know what?
I just got the
local
general
purchasing card. I'm going to be my
book. Let's take a look.
Okay.
Page 7.
I have to see here
real quick
to find something.
That's not the operating procedures. I'm going to suspend just what they want to do.
Well, there's one part, not quite yet, the one that Article 9, Finance and Section 1, Fiscal Management, on page 38, on the last sentence, the superintendent shall ensure that the board receives in a timely manner monthly financial statements and reports, corporate reports, and any other financial reports necessary or requested by the board. Now let me go over to this other page and see what it says.
Hold on.
So Don, are you saying that you feel if it's not a part of policy or operating procedures that we don't need to suspend?
I don't think it is.
And Eric can just start doing that?
I don't see it. I don't find it.
Right. We need to make a motion to suspend a portion of the policy identified after the time frame. But unless I misinterpreted Clarkfield's intent.
New language.
And if I'm wrong, I was going down the path of identifying the article and then actually becoming the authority of the board to do that. But if there's a better approach, do something else.
I don't think there's anything to suspend. It would be more about whether you want to act on it.
Anything in this part of the bureaucracy about that?
It's just our practice.
Right. So not, yeah, hold on. Let me double check that too.
I've done some searching of the word check and register in both documents and do not see that electronically.
I got it.
I remember after I asked about the usual, and I heard it was a practice.
Yeah, I think so.
That it had evolved, but I just figured it was rooted in some sort of policy, because that was what has been done.
This is Sharon. I believe it's something that has been had practice. I do remember this had been a flawless, I believe, board operating procedures that we had in the past. And I believe that was taken out. The current board operating and current bylaws and procedures, I'm not seeing it entered right now. Okay. So it's a past practice for sure, but it used to be in woman days. So to that point, I think we could easily just what we need to suspend and say
there was
thing there that we're not able to see at this particular time, we could just pull that out.
So it's none of those things. It would be.
So how does the board feel then moving forward? I don't believe we need to vote on anything. We don't need to motion or suspend anything. We can just allow the superintendent to proceed since he's not in violation of any policy or board operating procedures, since there one doesn't exist. We can just have the superintendent proceed in that manner, and then at another time, the board as a whole, we can have the discussion as an agenda item in regards to the check registry if we want to continue with the practice that we have and adding it to a policy
or
an operating procedure at that time.
Do we want to vote on some cursory?
Hillary, is Adam?
Yes, Adam?
I agree with all board members. I think the leader of the parents should have a policy to do the time to be, and is 100% done a fantastic job at this point, and I think we'll continue to do that. So I wholeheartedly give him my power to be able to do those types of things, especially when we have board members that feel that they are in risk. So let him have that ability to do those things.
I'm going to read the last thing.
I agree.
Okay.
This is Amy, and I agree.
Okay.
This is Dad. I support that also. I also ask that the superintendent would inform the board when those are action decisions.
And I don't know if I'm mute or not, but I agree and also want to let the board know that with scrap double transplant and some difficulties that he faced recently with very low white blood count, he's even more at risk than he was before. Yeah. So as a primary caregiver, I really have to be super careful.
Yes, absolutely. Yes. Stay home, Terry.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so then he will just continue, or he will work in that manner.
So I have individual statements from every board member that's on this call. Is that enough for me to proceed? I'm asking Hillary this question, or should we actually have a vote second and roll call on, we can relist the language provided by Clark Hill again, or what's the board's pleasure? To vote on that paragraph from Clark Hill, to be a temporary execution of myself, or just to allow me to do it based on everyone's individual comments, which I appreciate.
If someone wants to make the motion, I can reread the language and we can roll call, or we can move forward, whichever is the pleasure of the board.
Sharon, I think that we all agree that it's okay to give this to Eric, to ask him anything about any of our policies, but I think just because of the uniqueness of this, it's really good for us to make the motion and roll call it.
So are you making the motion, Sharon?
I'll read it again.
I can do that.
Okay. And do I have support?
Support.
Is that Mr. Hubler? I will read again the wording just so that we're in agreement. The wording states, during the pendency of any such state of emergency, the board hereby empowers the superintendent to bypass any board policy or bylaw necessary to ensure the continuity of operations, including but not limited to executing contracts, procurement, and the like. This bylaw shall not empower the superintendent to act in a manner that would violate any federal, state, or local law or ordinance, or to take unilateral action in violation of a prior resolution or finding of the Board of Education. Any discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Okay, what Hillary just said. Mrs. Ross votes yes on the partial Mr. Huber?
Yes.
Mr. Huber votes yes. Mr. Lipsky?
Yes.
Mr. Lipsky votes yes. Dr. Spencer?
Yes.
Dr. Spencer votes yes. Mrs. Servio?
Yes.
Mrs. Servio votes yes. And Mrs. Dubex?
Yes.
Mrs. Dubex votes yes. All set.
Wonderful. Motion carries. So, do you have anything,
sure,
Eric, before we...
Sure. Thank you very much for allowing that and allow us to move forward. I can't say how much I appreciate everyone's support during this time. It's just incredible that this has only been a little over 1 week since everything has changed. And we've got a bumpy road ahead, but we've done a lot of, I think, very positive things in a short period of time, and we'll continue to be dedicated to do such things. I've just updated the community again this evening with a communication about things that have just changed again over the past 48 hours in regards to information on state testing, AP tests, some information from the MDE about counting this as instructional time. Be assured that I'm on it when it comes to making sure that the interests of our students and our community are well taken care of during this time, and things are happening very quickly. If I will continue to communicate with the board and the public on these ever-changing issues, and I appreciate community, teachers, everyone's support. People have really been working hard. Just a quick note on the meals program. Just on Friday alone, we delivered, either by pickup or delivery, 12,000 meals to the community on Friday. So this is really, it's just a number of people contributing to this effort. We understand that today's order will modify some things going forward. We're trying to understand that more completely now. And we are trying to take care of and validate all employees during this process. So I, again, appreciate it. And everyone stay safe and look after your family, but look after and just make sure everyone's doing well and your neighbors as well. And I appreciate it personally and professionally. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
With that, do I have a motion to adjourn?
Oh, Sharon, wait.
Oh, Sharon?
I just, Sharon, just wanted to say before I remember from that too that, Eric, I am so appreciative of everything you're doing for our district, all the cabinet in there, and of course the employees that are helping with the meals for our students and board. I'm proud of all of us. I thank you all for being able to make this happen today and for the good and thoughtful conversation that we had this afternoon. It's a pleasure to work with everyone, and yes, everybody stay safe and healthy, and thank you all very, very much. Nikki, you're going to have work too. Thank you.
Absolutely.
With that,
this is I just want to make one quick comment. Eric, I am so proud of the work you've done over these few weeks. Our community should be proud of you, our district is proud of you, and it doesn't show us that we have the right superintendent, like, I don't know what does. forth, and whatever you need, please let us know. I'd also like to say that happy with Whitmore putting the same place. Eric needs to work from home as much as he can, because if Eric gets sick for any reason, it hurt tremendously. So we need to keep you safe, Eric. Appreciate everything you've done. I'm also very, very proud of this board that it's not easy to have a conference call and having a meeting like this. There's going to be some hiccups, and we've had our few, but I'm really proud to be working with this board. But again, Eric and Nikki, fantastic. Curriculum department, our entire board staff, fantastic job. And I am very, very happy we gave Eric the ability to work and make decisions for our district. And we all know that he will do the best he can. Thank you.
Thank you, Adam, and thank you, everyone else. It really is a team effort, and some people are doing this virtually, and some people are doing it on site, but there's a lot of people contributing to this, so thank you.
Yes, and I mirror the sentiments of all of our board members. Absolutely, our superintendent, Eric, you've gone above and beyond. You've definitely shown exceptional leadership in this time. We're all very proud of you, very proud of the work that you have done. I agree with Adam in regards to you're definitely the right person in the right job. Especially at the right time, and we are here to help you, to empower you, to support you, so that Lance Creuse can continue to be the exceptional district that it is.
Thank you.
So whatever you need, please feel free to reach out to us. We're here to support in any way that we can.
Yep. Thank you, everyone, again.
Yes. Anyone else?
Okay.
It's 7:11. 7:11 sounds like a great time to adjourn. Do I have a motion? I believe that was Sharon with support by Amy. What was that, Sharon?
Yes.
Okay, yes. So I have a motion to adjourn by Mrs. Ross with support by Mrs. Servio. May I have a roll call, please?
Yes. Mrs. Ross votes to adjourn. Mrs. Servio?
Yes.
Mr. Bay?
Yes.
Patrick Spencer?
Yes.
Mr. Olsky?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Olsky votes yes. Sorry, Dr. Spencer votes yes. Mr. Olsky votes yes. Mr. Huber?
Yes.
Wonderful. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye.